Devin Haney training with Floyd Mayweather. Brandon Krause, give me your assessment. What do you think of that?
Man, who wouldn't love to gain knowledge from Floyd Mayweather? So
anybody.
Yeah, anybody. And I've been seeing some of the work. It looks pretty productive and good.
Let me share a story with the viewers. A couple years ago, it's like 11 o'clock at night.
Yeah.
I get a call from Mayweather's people saying Mayweather needs sparring tonight. Ricky Funes was his gym. Ricky was in Mexico, Puerto Rico. He was out of the country. And I said, okay, Brandon, I just woke you up. You had like 3-4 beers.
Like, I was awake, but
tell
I,
people
I definitely
story.
Had the three
pick
or four
up the
beers.
People. Pick up the story from there.
Well, Elie Seckbach starts calling me at like 11:30 p.m. and I'm looking at my phone, and I'm looking at my beer, and I'm looking
you
at my
almost,
phone, and I almost chose the beer over you, Elie.
You almost sent me the voicemail.
But I answered your call, and yeah, sure enough, you said Floyd Mayweather needed sparring, and he needed it basically right then. And could I get a hold of my superstar Jesse Martinez?
Who's what is his record right now?
Right now he's 15-0. At the time he was 1-0.
Amazing, 15-0. Okay, go on.
But
El Mago, as they call him.
Yeah, and I knew the kid would say yes. I just didn't know if I was going to be able to get a hold of him because I was kind of in a cellular dead zone, and it was late at night.
It was late.
And like a good athlete, he goes to sleep early. Long story short, got a hold of him. Met you at 10 Goose Boxing. Thank you, Ricky Funes. And it was just you and a handful of people until the Mayweather caravan came. Next thing you know, it was 200 people packed in this little gym, all part of the money team. Everybody except for me, Jesse, and you, I guess. And Jesse, like the champion he is, he got in there and gave Floyd work, and there were these crazy 8-10 minute rounds, and it was just everything that you have seen on the 24/7s and the doghouse and the people banging on the ring, and it was just quite the experience, and it was very much a positive experience for Jesse Martinez.
When you called Jesse, he thought you were crank calling him. He told me that he thought you were joking.
Yeah,
you pull jokes at him like that?
I pull jokes every now and then.
So he thought this was like a parody, like, we're not going to.
It took some convincing, but he finally believed me.
In the end, Mayweather was very nice, took a picture, talked. Jesse told me that experience really helped him because if he could hang in there, if he could just last with Floyd, nobody in the ring could have hurt him.
It really did. And Jesse's had like kind of these milestones as his career's progressed, and that was one of them. And that was one of the biggies. And many years from now, Jesse will pull some young kid into the ring to spar with him, and it will be the same uplifting experience for them.
How was it for you to work opposite corner in front of Floyd Mayweather?
It was crazy. It was intense. At some point, I was giving Jesse advice, and I remember Floyd like stopping the sparring and looking at me and going, And then I'm like, as respectfully, I'm like, Champ, I'm here to help my guy, and I think Floyd respected that.
It was
that.
Basically you and him against 200 people.
Yeah.
And all in a good, fun, good sports way.
Yeah, I was not in fear of my safety or anything.
Was it a surreal experience? Did it feel like a movie almost? Like Mayweather at 2 o'clock in the morning?
It did, and that didn't wear off for quite some time, and still seems like a dream almost.